the first case of coronavirus reported from Chandigarh. A 21-year-old girl has been found to be coronavirus positive, and that's something, confirmation which came in the morning. The UT administration has gone into an alert mode. They have carried out several steps. We had the advisor to the UT administration come out in the morning, gave a briefing to the media informing what steps have been initiated. But the biggest worry, biggest thing, which is the biggest problem which the administration seems to be grappling with is the circulation of fake messages on the social media platforms. And in fact, the administration has warned those who've been circulating these fake WhatsApp messages, messages like there have been number of cases which have been detected, that the family members of this girl have also tested positive, and also certain areas of Chandigarh where they claim that number of cases have been reported. Now these, as far as the UT administration is concerned, are supposed to be fake messages, and action would be undertaken against those spreading such rumours. I'm joined by my colleague Naina Mishra, who's been tracking developments. Naina, first about these fake messages. What does the administration say?
The administration has said that all messages are fake, mm-hmm. and they're going to take a strict action against those spreading rumors. Right. So far, there's only one positive case in UT, and about the family members, mother is in isolation ward. She's been sampled, so the reports are likely to come by the evening or by the night.
Right.
The ambulance from GMCH 32 has dispatched, and they have gone to collect samples of brother and father.
Okay.
So far the samples reports has not come, and there's only one case in Chandigarh.
Okay, so put the record straight, only one confirmed case so far as Chandigarh is concerned, only one girl. Tell us something about the travel history of that girl.
The girl is a student of London Business School in
right.
UK.
Mm-hmm.
So since there has been a college shutdown in UK as well, so she came to her hometown
right.
On Saturday night.
Right.
She boarded Air India flight,
mm-hmm.
and she came from Amritsar. She landed on at Amritsar, and from there she came by cab
okay.
with her driver and
right.
father.
Right. Okay. Also, tell us about you had attended Mr. Parida's briefing in the morning. The administration obviously is on an alert mode. Give us some of the pointers from those from that press conference. The main important points.
Yeah. Three quarantine facility has been marked.
Right.
One is PJSRI Center.
Right.
Another is Panchayat Bhavan.
Mm-hmm.
And third is Parkview.
Right. And apart from that, what other steps the administration has taken?
Administration is going to differentiate between essential services and non-essential services.
Right.
Public dealing in offices have been closed.
Right.
Then
also, I think there have been a lot of rumors about the grocery shops, the vegetable markets being shut down. Can you just throw some light on that? What the administration saying?
Recently, in one of the markets, there was a panic going on.
Right.
So far, grocery markets and the mandis are not being shut because
right.
it's going to create a panic, and we cannot shut them overnight.
Absolutely.
So the administration going to take a slew of measures. They are taking slew of measures, and it's going to take some time for them to be shut.
Okay. Hmm. And also the public transport system, the UT buses, bus services, are they still plying, and any plans of shutting them down, or they're plying regularly?
They're plying regularly. Disinfection
right.
is being carried out, but
right.
Administration has not rolled out any guidelines on the CTU buses.
Right.
Sports complex are being shut.
Right.
That's it.
That's it. So as Naina clarified, so far, you know, there's been a lot of rumor mongering happening that, you know, big markets, vegetable markets have been shut down, even smaller markets have been shut down. That has resulted in some kind of a panic, some kind of hoarding by hoarders, and that's what the administration has denied. So far, the grocery shops, they have not been shut down. Vegetable markets, they are working as usual. So the administration has said that don't go by these rumors. They are initiating steps, and as Naina mentioned, to ensure that there is enough stockpile of essential commodities. Also, Naina, about the schools continue to remain shut, also the academies, that will remain shut till 31st.
Yes, that will. Yesterday only CBSE issued a guideline, and
right.
CBSE has also postponed board examination, so they are not going to continue, and schools are going to be shut. Teachers, however, are being trained.
Okay.
They are being trained to give trainings to the departments and how to carry on the basic hand washing and keeping themselves safe and keeping the sanitizers.
Okay.
So government officers till few days before were not equipped with the sanitizers, and even I visited some of the offices and I found that the staff was not given proper
okay.
hand washing facility and other precautions.
Okay. If you can throw some light also on the facilities available in our city hospitals, the government hospitals, mostly the PGI and other places, are there enough isolation wards, enough facilities being created in these hospitals?
We have three government office hospitals,
right,
which the UD administration has pulled in.
Right.
There is GMCH 32, there is GMSH 16, and there's PGI.
Right.
There are so far enough. The administration claims there are enough hospital isolation beds,
right,
but there are 200 ventilators, and if there is an epidemic,
right,
we fear that the hospital may not be able to.
Right.
So far, we are in the second stage of pandemic.
Right.
But if the transmission, if the transmission rate increases, so far there is no committee transmission.
Right.
So if this happens, so it will create a panic situation.
But also, for the benefit of our viewers, you've been talking to the doctors. So far, we have not come across a community transmission of this virus so far. Am I right?
Yes, not yet.
So that's
so far
one.
The cases we have only
right.
have a travel history.
Right.
As far as this case is concerned, there have been rumors, but health authorities are yet to clarify. The girl allegedly visited some of her friends.
Okay.
In some sectors, and
right.
she also visited a gathering, which is yet to be clarified.
Okay.
The hospital is doing contact tracing. So far, only four members are in the borderline.
Right.
The maid, the driver who had carried the girl from Amritsar to Chandigarh, the father and the mother. Mother is already in the isolation ward.
Right.
Rest will come as the report come from the authorities.
Okay. So far, the administration claiming they are well prepared to meet any eventuality.
Yes, so far the administration claiming, but rest is to be seen.
Okay.
Yes.
Thank you so much, Naina. So there you have, Naina, as you heard, giving us a latest update on the situation evolving in Chandigarh. As I mentioned, there have been a lot of rumors, there have been a lot of fake messages going on around the WhatsApp groups and also on other social media platforms. That is something that the administration has taken very seriously. They're saying that action will be initiated. We suggest that, you know, only those messages which come from authentic official sources should be trusted, and those which are not really coming from the official channels, they should not be forwarded by any of these WhatsApp users. That's something the message which is out from the UT administration. We'll keep on providing you updates on the latest updates on coronavirus. You can also log on to our website www.tribuneindia.com and also on our other social media platforms like Facebook and also Twitter. Meanwhile, thanks for watching.